my son late at night on Instagram. You need to train your teachers better. They should not be. Hey, you guys wanted to see me?
Mr. Ramirez, due to complaints from a certain mother, you're going to have to hand over your phone for investigation.
For what exactly?
Certain reasons.
Here.
Okay, so after watching that scenario, why is it an option?
Well, see, you don't know what's going through the student's head at that moment, and you might not be able to afford to wait until the next day to talk to them in person. Sometimes the most direct approach is the best one.
On to the next scenario.
Come in.
Hey, you wanted to see me?
Yes, please sit down. Mr. Ramirez, did you happen to receive a private message from one of your students about a certain... Okay, so after watching scenario two, why do you think it's a good idea?
Well, she would be breaking personal five or her contract because it's her private social media, and her not responding keeps her kind of within those boundaries of her contract.
Now on to scenario three.
Do you have a second?
Sure.
Sir, last night I received a message from one of my students on Instagram. He's claiming he's being bullied by another student, and as first year teacher, I don't know what steps to take.
Okay, so after watching scenario three, why is it viable?
I think waiting until mediation is very important because it doesn't go against principle five, which is proper use of technology. It helps keep professionalism between her and her student, and it's best to always get the proper authorities involved.
So after viewing all of the scenarios, I would really appreciate it if you went into more detail on why you think responding to the message would be the best option.
Well, I feel like it's the only option that'll work. See, you have no idea what's going through this kid's head. And at that moment, in the middle of the night, he is so worried that he's willing to message the teacher over social media even. You need to know what's going on in his head, and there is a really quick and easy solution for that, which is just responding to the message. You can find out instantly what's going on in his head and then help him.
And what platform was it?
Instagram, I think.
Okay, so the main issue with responding on Instagram is principle five, the responsible and ethical use of technology, and using your private social medias completely goes outside of that contract.
And principle five is very important when you become a teacher, as well as responding immediately to this message on Instagram late night. It instantly puts the school in charge of possibly investigating into it more. You might not have the right resources to just respond to this message, and your life is immediately on the line.
So maybe it's not a great idea.
Yeah, so I think we're definitely going to take your option off of the table.
After taking his scenario off the table for really obvious reasons, I'd love to hear you elaborate on why you think he should ignore the message overall.
If Mr. Ramirez ignores it, she's following her contract with the school, and that also involves Principle 5 and ethical and responsible use of technology. And it could also be like a very good learning experience for her to private her Instagram and any other social media so that her students can't get a hold of her. And this would also be a great way of maybe looking into classroom management and like setting boundaries for her students.
I love the teacher learning from this situation. I think that's a very good point. The situation though, however, could escalate for the student. We don't know what's going on. It's very urgent, clearly, if he's reaching out to you. I just don't think it would be the best situation to just completely ignore it.
I understand where you're coming from, but I think looking at my situation could be easier for me also to look at yours and like looking at your positives. So what would you say are your positives for yours?
obviously, ignoring till mediation, to respect the student as well, you can also bring in the fact that getting proper authorities involved can help him not be so scared of Mandy's mother retaliation, because obviously, principal can take care of that and it won't be on him or the teacher. You as well learn classroom management. She can learn from this, she can private the message and still wait till mediation. And it just helps being professional overall. Instead of responding, even looking out into outside resources, she could email him back in the morning or just use proper line of communication. And it, again, lessens the chance of losing her job.
I think one of the downfalls of that is if the school doesn't handle the retaliation from the student and the parent, Ms. Ramirez would then have to handle that outside of school. So obviously, like, there's multiple, like, positives and negatives for, well, a negative for each of ours. I feel like there might be something that we're kind of missing.
Why don't we just go ask an expert?
You can look at the camera.
Okay. I would certainly recommend pursuing mediation in this situation, because in education, making any decisions that can impact students definitely harmfully, you want to make sure you're not alone. So collaborating with an administrator in this case is the teacher's best possible option, because that will be a way to ensure that due diligence was taken and there was no negligence in making sure that that student was protected and that any element of the story or situation is fully vetted and understood. When dealing with social media, when dealing with students who feel that they've been bullied or harassed in any way, administrators should be involved in the conversation and able to provide insights, offer solutions, or investigate further. The fact that another employee is also involved in this means that providing the administrator the opportunity to arbitrate and mediate between the students and the staff members can be really key to making sure there's long-lasting success and making sure everyone feels safe and supported moving forward.
Those are beautiful words. I honestly feel inspired.
It definitely made me think, definitely missed that point of negligence. I didn't even think about that. So, I can definitely see why yours is the best option. I think we should definitely go with that.
I agree. I think waiting till mediation is the best scenario.
Here, here.
I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all.